Hello everyone, today we are going to demonstrate active rectifier characterization using the PE-DAQ system. My name is Hamza Tariq and I'm an applications engineer at Taraz Technologies. The active rectifier under test is part of a programmable DC power supply. The topology used is a diode bridge combined with a single boost converter. A low number of components make this topology cost-effective with a decent power factor of 0.952. However, the input current is non-sinusoidal, which results in a high total harmonic distortion of around 32%. The connections are made to measure voltages and currents in a 3-wire 3-wattmeter configuration. Since measurements are taken on phase currents and line-to-line voltages, a phase shift will exist between voltage and current waveforms. Here is the experimental setup for the test. Now, we just connect the input terminal, turn on the rotary switch, and initiate the power supply. After setting the voltage and turning it on, we move to the analysis window and connect the PE-DAQ. Now we simply click on auto set, and here we have the voltage and current waveforms. You can see that the currents minus the distortions look similar to the ideal current waveform for the selected topology as discussed earlier. Here is a downloadable IntelliSENS recording file for this experiment. We can add measurements for RMS values of voltages and currents, which are around 380 volts and 7 amps. Notice that the voltages, like any other non-ideal grid voltage, seem to have some distortions. Let's analyze the distortion in grid voltage as they will ultimately affect the current waveforms as well. For that, we move to the Harmonic Analysis tab, select a voltage channel and compute the results. Okay, so we have around 5% THD on the grid side. We can also view the results in tabular form as well. Similarly, we can get THD value for the current, which is around 32% as anticipated. Finally, we will perform power analysis to get power factor along with the output power. We select a three-phase system in a 3-wire 3-wattmeter configuration. After pairing up appropriate voltages and currents, we can compute the power quality. Here, you can see the power factor is 0.96, which is quite good and easily satisfies our criteria. Thank you for watching this demonstration. You can also download the recording file and perform this analysis yourself. If you have any questions, do not hesitate to leave a comment below.